malaria thin smear preparation, staining and examination. The thin peripheral blood smear is used primarily for species identification of malarial parasite. The thin smear preserves the structure of individual parasites with minimum structural distortion. Sample collection.
Thin films can be made from whole or anticoagulated blood. EDTA whole blood venous sample or capillary blood.
Thick and thin smears must be prepared immediately after the whole blood is drawn. If anticoagulants are used, the blood must be drawn in a lavender or pink top EDTA tube. Invert the EDTA tube several times to avoid the coagulation of blood. The tube of preserved blood must be received in the laboratory within 1 hour of collection for best results. If it is anticipated that the EDTA tube will not arrive in the laboratory within 1 hour, prepare thick and thin smears according to the following instructions and send the slides and the EDTA tube to the laboratory immediately. Equipment. Clean, grease-free glass slides and applicator sticks. Preparation of thin smears. Use universal precautions while preparing the smears for malarial parasites. Use clean and dry microscopic glass slides. Clean them with lint-free cloth. Label a glass slide with sample identification number. Mix the sample by inversion. Open the cap gently and check for clots by dipping the applicator stick in the tube. Place a drop of blood on one edge of a clean, grease-free glass slide. Place another slide at a 30 degrees to 45 degree angle up to the drop, allowing the drop to spread along the contact line of the two slides. This angle is important to prevent the leukocytes from bunching along the edges. Quickly push the upper slide toward the other end of the lower slide. Use the correct amount of blood and proper spreading technique to obtain a tongue-shaped smear or a smear with a good feathered edge. The thickness of the smear varies when the slide is pushed at various rates. The slower the motion, the thinner the smear. If the smear is too thick, the structural detail of individual parasites will not be observable. A well-prepared film is thick at one end and thin at the other. That is, a single layer of evenly distributed RBCs with no cell overlap. The thin, feathered end should be at least 2 cm long and the film should occupy the central area of the slide with free margins on both the ends. Air dry in a box or other container to prevent dust from settling on the slides. Do not dry with heat. Staining. A number of Romanowski stains like Fields, Jimsa, Wright's and Leishman's are suitable for staining the smears. Thin blood films stained by Jimsa's or Leishman's stain are useful for speciation of parasites, for the stippling of infected red cells. The optimal pH of this buffer is 7.2. Here, the staining by Leishman's stain will be demonstrated. Leishman's stain. After the smear dries, label the slide on the thick edge of the smear with another glass slide or a diamond marking pencil. This is done as the earlier markings can be washed away while staining. Next, place the dried slide on the staining rack. Add 7 to 8 drops of the stain. Leave for about 1 to 2 minutes. Then add 12 to 15 drops of buffered distilled water using a disposable dropper. Mix thoroughly. Leave for 4 to 8 minutes. Then wash off with clean water. Wipe the back of the slide with clean cotton to prevent stain deposits, which can hamper the reading of the slide. Dry the slide and examine. Note, whenever a new lot of stain is received, verify the new lot. Stain 4 to 8 slides using different durations of staining and check which slide is stained the best. use the same duration of staining for that lot of stain. Now, examination of the stained smear. Place the slide on the mechanical stage of the microscope. Focus the slide first using the 10x objective. Position the 100x oil immersion objective over the edge of the film where the red cells are the thinner. Place a drop of immersion oil on the edge of the middle of the film. Lower the oil immersion objective until it touches the immersion oil. Examine the blood film by moving along the edge of thin film, then moving the slide inwards by one field, returning in a lateral movement, and so on. Examine a minimum of 200 fields in a thin film. Parasitic index. To quantify the malarial parasites, count the parasitized RBCs among 500 to 2000 RBCs on the thin smear and express the results as percent parasitemia. Percent parasitemia is equal to parasitized RBCs divided by total RBCs multiplied by 100. Identification of malarial parasites. Malarial parasites take up stain in a special way in both thick and thin blood films that enables to distinguish the various parts of the parasite. They pass through a number of developmental stages. In all the stages, the same parts of the parasite will stain with the same color. Chromatin, or part of the parasite nucleus, is usually round in shape and stains deep red. Cytoplasm occurs in a number of forms, from ring shapes to irregular shapes. It always stains blue, although the shade of blue may vary between the malarial species. Stages of the malarial parasites that are seen in peripheral blood films are ring form. It is the earliest stage seen in all species of Plasmodium, seen as single or multiple rings with cytoplasm ring and chromatin dot. Trophozoid stage. This stage is most commonly seen. The trophozoid stage is a growing stage. The parasite within the red blood cell may vary in size from small to quite large. Pigment appears as the parasite grows. The malaria pigment is a byproduct of the growth or metabolism of the parasite. It doesn't stain but has a color of its own, which may range from pale yellow to dark brown or black. Schizont stage. During the Schizont stage, the malarial parasite starts to reproduce. This reproduction is referred to as asexual reproduction, as the parasite is neither male nor female but reproduces itself by simple division. Seen sometimes in P. vivax and P. malariae. The gametocyte is the sexual stage in which the parasites become either male or female in preparation for the next stage, which is the extrinsic phase, which takes place in the stomach of the female Anopheles mosquito. Gametocytes may be either round or banana shaped, depending on the species. The various species of malarial parasites are: there are four species of malarial parasites that affect the humans. 1. P. vivax. P. vivax is the commonest species in India. It is the largest of the malarial parasites found in humans. 2. Plasmodium falciparum, which is also the common species in India and is responsible for conditions like cerebral malaria and even death. 3. P. malariae. P. malariae is a less common species in India, prevalent in some parts of Orissa, Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. 4. P. ovale. This is not prevalent in India but is reported from many countries, especially from Africa. It is important to identify the various species as treatment regimen differs with the type of malarial parasite seen on smear and thus the importance of thin smears. Comparison of different malarial species on a thin smear. P. falciparum.
Infected RBC are normal in size and RBCs are infected by multiple parasites.
P. vivax has infected RBCs which are enlarged in size, they may show Schaffner's dots. P. malariae, the infected RBCs are normal in size. The ring form in P. falciparum are the delicate rings with one or two chromatin dots. In P. vivax, large rings, usually single with large chromatin dot. In P. malariae, sturdy cytoplasm with large chromatin dot. Trophozoites, P. falciparum, not usually seen. In P. vivax, in enlarged RBCs with Schaffner's dots. In P. malariae, compact cytoplasm with large chromatin with some band forms. Schizonts in P. falciparum, not usually seen. In P. vivax, seen as large structure with 12 to 24 merozoites with yellow-brown pigment. In P. malariae, 6 to 12 merozoites with large nuclei clustered around a mass of coarse, dark-brown pigment. Gametocytes. In P. falciparum, they are crescent or sausage-shaped with clumped or scattered chromatin stretching the RBCs. In P. vivax, they are round to oval, almost filling the RBC with scattered brown pigment. In P. malariae, it's round to oval with scattered brown pigment. They may almost fill the infected red blood cell. Next, quality control. One slide can be reviewed by the two lab persons to study the accuracy and inter-observer variance. If feasible, inter-lab comparisons can be done once in 6 months with two NABL accredited labs.